Good afternoon, Rahul ji. Myself, Kum.Shakeena from KVR degree college, Kurnool. Today, I'm going to question about...
What are you studying?
BA Advanced English, specialized in computer science and history, sir.
And are you hopeful of getting a job?
Sir?
Are you hopeful of getting a job?
Yes, sir.
Where will you get a job? Where will you work?
Sir, we are specially trained in JKC so that we can improve our communication skills and soft skills so that we can face our interviews so nicely and confidently.
But your communication skills are pretty good.
Thank you, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, I'm going to question about the insecurity of women and girls in India. Lot of acts like Nirbhaya acts are executed in India, but day by day the crime rates are increasing but not decreasing. Daily the 3-year-old child to 80-year-old woman are being raped. I think the unborn girl child thinks that she feels happy when she is killed in the womb itself better than seeing the world after being alive. What are the measures and steps are you going to take to feel safe, to assure the girl child to be secured in India? What are the measures are you taking to make India a safe India?
I was asked this question yesterday in Madhya. Girls asked me this question.
Yes, sir.
They asked me, why is it that India has become so unsafe for women? Why is it that we feel uncomfortable when walking on the streets? There are a number of reasons for it. One is, and I'm not happy to say this, but one is the attitude of Indian men towards women. It is, most Indian men do not see women as their equals. And I think this is something that we have to change. We have to change this attitude. I, for one, believe that women are as capable of men and women can do anything that a man can do. So that is one cultural thing that has to be changed. The second thing is, women do not have enough place in government and in politics. So we have a bill in the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, which we have told the Prime Minister that he should pass. And we have committed to him that the moment the Prime Minister wants to pass the Women's Reservation Bill in Parliament, the Congress Party MPs will support it wholeheartedly. He has not responded. Women's presence in police stations, women's presence in the police, dedicated police stations for women, dedicated systems so women can make their complaints comfortably, these are another aspect of the problem, and this is also something that the Congress Party is promising in its manifesto. We want you to be comfortable when you go to police stations. We want you to speak to women police officers so you can tell them your problems and what you're dealing with. And finally, this I would recommend to all of you. We need you in the political parties. Wherever you look, you will find male leaders. One after the other, you will find male leaders. We want more and more women to be involved in politics. Women like you should come, join us, and change the nature of the politics so women can walk freely and comfortably on the streets. One thing I want to point out. Some months ago, there was a rape carried out in Uttar Pradesh by a member of Legislative Assembly of the BJP. A BJP leader was involved in the rape of a woman. And it is not the only example. There are other examples of BJP leaders harassing women, beating up women, and being involved in these type of activities. And when this happened, I was very sad to see that the Prime Minister did not condemn what one of his MLAs had done. The Prime Minister has to show the direction to the country. And when the Prime Minister keeps quiet when women are beaten up, when there is a rape, when one of his MLAs rapes someone, a message goes to the country that this is not a high priority. And then people take this example and do whatever they want. So it is very important that the top leadership of the country is very clear that this type of stuff is not acceptable. And if this type of stuff happens, people will be acted against. No action was taken against that person from the BJP. So it is a question of attitude, it is a question of the top leadership being aggressive, and it is also involving women in politics, involving women in the police force, and making women feel part of the country. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.